So I got this email recently from somebody who had developed rhabdo from working out, and I thought I'd make a good video for those who may be struggling with this disorder. So let me just start off by reading you the email. So he says that 4 days prior, he goes back to the gym to try to start working out again, lifting weights. And this is after taking a 3 year layoff from the gym. He notices that his urine is starting to look like soda. I'm going to take that to mean the classic dark colored urine symptom, which many people report. And he originally thought it was due to the protein shake he was drinking. However, then he decided to start drinking a lot of water to try to flush out his kidneys. That'll work out for a while, but then the dark colored urine returned. He's experiencing some muscle soreness, which again, we can't tell right now from what he's saying whether this is regular muscle soreness or this is muscle soreness resulting from rhabdo. See my previous videos on how to tell the difference between regular muscle soreness and muscle soreness from rhabdo, which oftentimes hurts a lot worse than regular muscle soreness. And then he ends the email by mentioning my suggestion that I think you should be free of all symptoms before returning to the gym after getting rhabdo, and then mentions that if his lab values are normal and he has no more muscle soreness, is it okay to go back to the gym? And last sentence is, in the meantime, is it safe to do some running? So I'll start off by mentioning that he drank a lot of water when he noticed his urine color was changing, and that's a very common tactic. However, I do like to point out that not everybody with rhabdo experiences the dark colored urine symptom. And when you do drink water because you think you have rhabdo, that only deals maybe with the kidney problems that can arise from rhabdo. Rhabdo is much more than just kidney problems, which is all the more reason why I keep telling people that if you think you have rhabdo, the safest course of action is to get to a doctor and get checked out. So as for my suggestion on when to return to working out after getting rhabdo, so my normal suggestion is I think generally people should take 1 or 2 months off as a rule. I know that's much more conservative than what you may be hearing from other people. However, I've encountered several people over the years who went back too soon and got rhabdo again. So as a rule of thumb, and I go into more detail on this in my book on rhabdo, I think you should be free of all symptoms when you're doing your daily activities first. And by daily activities, I mean things like going to the supermarket, taking out the trash, walking up and down steps, and stuff like that. Once you're not experiencing any issues like fatigue or swelling or intense muscle pain with your daily activities, then you can start thinking about going back to the gym. Now, when you do go start working out, whether it's after you've had rhabdo or after you've had a long layoff, like this individual mentions that he hadn't worked out in 3 years. So the first thing I would say is if you have not worked out in a long time, okay, I suggest that you not start with the same workout you did before you took the layoff. In other words, if you're working out 4 days a week and you were doing leg day and chest day and chest and back day and arm day and all that jazz, don't do that when you first go back to working out again. That is the biggest mistake I think people make. They train the way they used to train when they were working out regularly. So if you haven't worked out in a long time, you are a novice. And I would consider you a novice if you haven't worked out in 3 months regularly. So if you start off doing what you're not used to doing, that is what triggers a lot of cases of rhabdo. It's when we do a lot of stuff that we're not used to doing. So whether you're returning to exercise after you've had rhabdo or you're returning to exercise after a long layoff, there should be no leg day, chest and back day, no arm day, none of that stuff. I think people should start with one set per exercise, one set of leg press, one set of lat pull down, one set of bicep curl, etc. And while we're on the topic, generally, I would not suggest doing an exercise that actively involved the muscle groups that had rhabdo. For example, if you had rhabdo in your biceps, which I hear a lot of people getting, then I wouldn't do a lot of bicep curls. I would avoid them, specifically in the beginning. And why is that? Well, because I want to be even more conservative. But also keep in mind that every upper body exercise you do involves the arms. Therefore, you really are working biceps, even though you're not specifically doing biceps. Of curls. Now, this individual also mentions if he could do some running before he goes back to the gym. And again, I would point out that I think it's best to start with less before starting with more. In other words, don't start with running. Start with walking. Take some walks around the neighborhood first. See how you feel with that. And when you do go back to the gym, maybe just hop on a treadmill or an elliptical for 5 or 10 or 15 minutes and see how you feel after that. Start with low intensity activity before bumping up the intensity. So I would not start with running. I would start with walking. So one other thing I'd point out, that when you are just starting an exercise program again after a long layoff, or even when you're coming back from getting rhabdo, the thing to remember is that it's going to take about 2 to 3 months before your nervous system adapts to the rigors of training. These are called neurological adaptations. And the easiest way to describe them is, in the beginning of exercise, your muscles and your brain speak different languages. It's going to take a few months for the muscles and the nervous system to communicate effectively. These neurological adaptations are actually what's responsible for the vast majority of strength improvements you see for the first few months of training. And you can't speed this up by training more times per week. So if you're just beginning an exercise program, or you're returning to exercise after getting rhabdo, I wouldn't go back to 3 or 4 or 5 days of training outright immediately. I would start with maybe 1 day per week in the beginning, just to see how you feel and to, again, calm down any kind of muscle soreness you might experience. A lot of people deal with what I call a PTSD-like syndrome after getting rhabdo, and it's real. I've heard it from a lot of people. They say the same thing to me over and over again. I've never heard of this condition before. It was the worst pain I've ever experienced, and I'm terrified to exercise again. So if you are returning to exercise, let's try to dampen down that psychological trauma of rhabdo, and let's say work out 1 day a week and build your confidence, and do that for several weeks or months until you feel confident enough to maybe do 2 times a week. At the end of the day, when you're dealing with rhabdo, it's about time and patience. Time and patience are your very best friends. I want to do more of these videos because I do believe that education is the best defense against rhabdomyolysis. So if you have any questions, leave them below, and I'll maybe do some future videos on them. And until next time, take care out there.